heard about the Loveland Pass Challenge, but when I think of Lincoln, I think of luxury. They don't necessarily think of racing.
The V6 Lincoln and the other cars sounds like an interesting experiment. I don't know if the Lincoln will be able to pull it off.
I'd probably go with the Maserati.
I think the BMW on a hill climb would probably win.
If Lincoln has a V6 that can compete with European brands, that'd be a great thing to see.
These are our goals. The number one goal is to get all five cars up that hill and tested.
We obviously thought it was really cool that Lincoln engineers thought that maybe their EcoBoost V6 could beat these European V8s. But we knew who would believe this if they ran the test. It just sprung really fully formed in my head. We should do the test.
6 a.m., get in the cars, drive to Loveland Pass. Don, you can start setting up the Jaguar, which is going to make the first run up the hill with V-Box.
We use a piece of test equipment called V-Box. Basically, it links up with 10 or so satellites through this antenna, and this box records everything the car does, time, position, velocity, everything you need to do a full data analysis.
What's interesting to me here is that this is power to weight, you know, and then this becomes much more handling oriented on this end. This challenge, I think, will be a great way to change public opinion relative to smaller engines. In the past, the thinking has been, if it's a luxury car, it's got to have a V8. If we can show that this EcoBoost V6 gets the job done as well as, or maybe even better than, the V8s, then I think that's a key way to start moving perception in that direction.
EcoBoost is an interesting, ambitious technology. Both turbocharging and direct fuel injection have been around for a long time. The magic is combining them, and the results are lower fuel consumption, maximum power with low emissions.
Well, we started the EcoBoost program to find a solution for rising fuel prices, and that would blend the performance of a V8 with the fuel economy of a V6.
Well, this is by far the most exciting product I've worked on. We have twin turbochargers plus direct injection, and that's exciting from an engineering perspective. And the very first time we hit the gas, all of a sudden the car just instantly threw you back in the seat, and you're like, wow, we nailed it.
What really defines the EcoBoost engine against large V8s is a nice, flat, linear torque curve. Torque is what actually accelerates the vehicle. It's that seat of the pants kick that you feel when you step on the gas.
They've had designers working like crazy on this lineup, and now they have a car with a very impressive twin turbocharged six-cylinder engine. It will have an advantage at altitude, but if it can beat these European luxury V8s, it is a little David and Goliath. We like it. It's a cool story.
I think this is like competing at the Olympics. You've got some of the best in the world we're competing with, and we're going to give these vehicles a run for their money.
Being in elevation gives the turbochargers an opportunity to really perform, so there's a distinct possibility that we are definitely going to smoke them.
Lincoln had the confidence in this car. And you have to admire engineering confidence. But right from the beginning, I said, it might not win.